Back, ladies and gentlemen. So, Lori Vallow and her attorney, Mr. Means, are back in the news again. And today, we're going to look at the list of people that her attorney, Mr. Means, has requested information on. And it's very broad, and it is asking for a lot of information that I didn't know that they necessarily could gather on or report on and use as part of this case. So let's jump into it. Thank you for joining me today. Lori Daybell's attorney requests information on more than 15 people from the Madison County prosecutor. Going to Rexburg, Idaho today, Lori Vallow's attorney is making another request to the Madison County prosecutor's office for more information related to his client's case. Mark Means sent an 8-page letter to prosecuting attorney Robert Woods last week as a follow-up to Woods' response to 3 requests Means filed in March and April. In those requests, Means asked for audio and video recordings, email, text messages, social media posts, voicemails, notes, reports, and other information regarding Daybell and her husband, Chad Daybell, and a variety of other people. Daybell is facing felony charges after the remains of her 7-year-old son, J.J. Vallow, and 16-year-old daughter, Tylee Ryan, were found buried on Chad Daybell's Salem property. Wood responded by providing Means with some of the information and objecting to parts of the request, saying his office did not have some of what he is asking for, and stated portions of Means' requests are vague, overly broad, and unduly burdened. In a letter dated October 19th, Means says Wood's response were not sufficient. A copy of the letter from the source, not the Madison County Prosecutor's Office, has been released to eastidahonews.com. After careful review, your response lacks compliance. This is in good faith attempt to resolve this issue prior to filing a motion to compel, writes Mr. Means. Please provide the full and complete response no later than 5 p.m. Thursday, October 29th, 2020, to my office. Mr. Means is asking for audio, video recording, communications, email, text, social media posts, voicemails, videos, statements, pictures, police reports, agency reports, notes, charts, graphs, and other things regarding the following people that you will now see here on the screen. Means also requested jailhouse records and letters between Chad and Lori, and autopsy and toxicology reports for JJ and Tylee, as well as the Daybell's former respective spouses, Tammy Daybell and Charles Vallow. Wood issued the following statement to East Idaho News by letter afterwards. In our justice system, prosecutors have the sole obligation to ensure a fair trial for every defendant. This is the response that I take just as seriously as I do my obligation to protect the safety of our community. As an important part of ensuring the part of the trial for the defendant is provided appropriate information pertaining to the case to the defendant, we have provided Mr. Means with a large amount of the information he requested, as well as investigation items, analysis, and other things that he has requested as of yet so far. Another critical part of protecting the defendant's right to a fair trial is avoidance of unnecessary pretrial publicity, such as inappropriate releases of this letter. For this reason, we have not and will not attempt to litigate this matter in the media. Lori Daybell has pled not guilty to 2 felony counts of conspiracy to commit destruction, alteration, or concealment of evidence. She remains in the Madison County Jail on $1 million bond. As of the end of April, and again since then, the last hearing in April, Lori Daybell has unable to attain the needed collateral for a bond. There have been several members who have stepped up to want to provide the cash portion of the bond, but she has not yet been able to find a security in interest of property that is in excess of $1 million. Chad Daybell is set to appear in court with his attorney, John Pryor, on Thursday to oppose a motion that Chad and Lori's trials should be combined. Woods argues that the case should be joined on the fact that the changes alleged they participated in the same acts and series of acts to conspire to commit alleged acts or series of acts. I didn't know that they could request such information from people who were not directly involved in the case. And on top of the request that Mr. Means has asked from the prosecutor, he wants his charts, his notes, his graphs. He wants everything that he has done on this case since it began, to know everything that the prosecution is going to possibly put forth as a motive, means, or anything at all. I didn't know that you could do this in a case. Apparently you can request it, but as you heard from what I just read, he's going to take him to court and he's going to file that he is not getting the proper information that he has requested. So thank you for joining me today. You stay safe out there.